Crisis, Lord, this is Charity Ebwesena, Christian Liberty Center, and I just want to continue with the fact that the reason why Christians are easily led and misled is because they don't read their Bible. And do you know, Bible has a reaction it does in your body when you read it? And eventually, if you're somebody who practices reading the Bible, I don't think that memorizing it would be a problem to you, because the Bible records itself in your heart. Once, you know, the Bible says that the Holy Ghost will remind you. Re means second time. If you haven't read the Bible, when in your time of trouble, Holy Ghost hasn't got anything to remind you. That's why many of you are in trouble. You Christians that don't read your Bible. Because many of you don't read your Bible. You know, I have been to a church that teaches you have to read it and understand it before you go. No, just read. Of course, there'll be time for Bible study and you stop to read it and understand it. Every Christian should have a program where they finish the Bible in a year and then come back. By the time you're 4 years a Christian, nobody will deceive you. Do you know how the Bible works? Once your spirit man has seen it, when an error comes, it wakes up to say, no. So place in the Bible didn't say that. Reading the Bible is training your spirit man, feeding your spirit man. It's spiritual training. And there are so many theological things that kill Christians. It's when they say you study, you say you read 10 chapters. How much of it do you understand? Understanding comes from God. You need to first visit it. You need to first visit it. If you don't know, and if you haven't read any at all, you don't know anything there, when there is trouble, the Holy Ghost has nothing to remind you. I had been in serious troubles in my dream, and the Lord will give me a scripture. Don't forget, a book, chapter, and then my spirit kicks off to say, oh, he said this and that and that. You know, and that will be the end of it. But it was a serious spiritual trouble. And if I didn't win like that in the dream, it would be difficult to win when you wake up. You have to win it. And you have to be a very, very strong person that you wake up and fly out of bed and attack it immediately. Immediately. And then you need to be careful with the social media over this coronavirus. There are so many things that are not, that people are emphatically, dogmatically asserting. Okay, now, everyone is gone quiet. Where are the leaders, Christian leaders in Nigeria? I wanted to say Africa, but I'm a Nigerian. Let me say Nigerian. If it was like a man's head, hey, they would all be all over the place teaching, and the women are the servants. They're inferior to men. Man is master. Where's the master now? He is dying as well as the servants. Why don't you all get together? Where are those gigantic Christian leaders that fly their plane? I want to see you people get together, pass a decree against coronavirus, and it will stop. If it is because of sins of human beings, you gigantic ones, if you know Jesus, get yourself together, pass a decree, and be an intercessor like Daniel. Not staying there collecting tithes and offerings. You need to do something. Those of you that they call mommy and daddy, arise. This is the time of your showing. Get yourself together, in Nigeria especially. They've shut every place down, not even leaving food shops. Other countries, at least, they left essential shops. Here we have Wilco is open. Morrison is open. Sainsbury's is open in England. Essential shops are open, but in Nigeria, they shut everywhere, blanketing blank. You Christians, arise and be doing. It's not when he reaches man's head. Every day you're teaching man's head. Every day it's obeying that have the rule over you. This is the time for those that have the rule to show themselves worthy so that people don't die. And don't you go taking corona vaccination, because it's corona itself. Let them go do it first in Wuhan. Vaccinate Wuhan people. That's where corona first showed up. And then go to Italy, the second place that 5G was planted. Go vaccinate people with coronavirus. And then they go to Spain, the third place they put 5G. Go vaccinate people. Let them not give you coronavirus. Don't buy. Don't accept free, because it will kill you. corona vaccination. It's not right. It's not right. Go and pray to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, and he will save you. Look, the Bible says, let's go to the book of Joshua, the man of God. Joshua, the battle fighter. Joshua killed 12 kings in one day. The Bible says, and all these kings and their kingdoms did Israel take because the Lord God of Israel fought for Israel. Listen, Joshua chapter 1 verse 8 says, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Listen to verse 9. It says, have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed, for Jehovah thy God is with thee everywhere thou goest. So don't be afraid. Don't let them talk you in fear. And I want to see Christians arise, make intercession, yes, and confess the sins of the people, yes, more so pass decrees, decree that is stopped. If the two of you shall agree as touching anything they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father who is in heaven. It will be done. Who is in heaven? All those Nigerian evangelists with their aeroplanes, you need to get together and pass a decree against coronavirus and this onslaught in the name of Jesus. That's your job. That's what you owe those people. You've been collecting their money. Even when they can't eat, they will take their money. And when they haven't fed their children, they will take their money and put in your bag of tithes and offerings. This is what you owe them now, to stand up and stop the plague. If the devil has put fear in your heart, I want to give you tablets for it. I want to give you prescription for it. I'm reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 41, from verses 10 to 12. It says, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Behold, all they that were incensed against thee shall be ashamed and confounded. They shall be as naught, and they that strive with thee shall perish. Thou shalt seek them and shall not find them. Even them that contended with thee, they that war against thee shall be as nothing and as a thing of naught. For I, Jehovah thy God, will hold thy right hand, saying unto thee, fear not, I will help thee. That's what the Bible said. And if you go to the book of Isaiah chapter 45, it says, I said not unto the seed of Jacob, seek ye me in vain. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, you're not seeking God in vain. You go back to him and say, Lord, I am so sorry for us human beings, what we have done to bring this coronavirus on us, as we have cooperated with the devil. I plead the blood of Jesus and I cover my family with the blood of Jesus, my loved ones, my blood relatives. We shall not lose anyone to coronavirus. In Jesus' name. That's all it takes. But if you start saying something else after you have said it, that would be you, not God. Not God. Coronavirus is not in heaven. Jesus told us to pray that as the will of God is done in heaven, let it be so on earth. There is no coronavirus in heaven. So God can't give it. The Bible, Jesus told us again, search the scripture, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, and there are they which testify of me. He's telling you that's where your answers are. That's found in the book of John, chapter 5, verse 39. You search the scripture, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, and there are they which testify of me. In the name of Jesus, Jesus is Lord. I would like all of you to arm yourself with the Bible so that the devil deceive you not. If it means dying, that when you die, you go straight to heaven. In Jesus' name. I want to introduce this book to you. It has the man of God who wrote this book is dead and gone to heaven for his reward. It has fantastic testimonies of how miracles that were done after pleading the blood of Jesus and believing that the same miracles will be repeated against coronavirus when you use it. If you can find it, it says the name of it is The Power of the Blood. It's written by Maxwell White. H.A. Maxwell, Maxwell White, yeah? You can, I got this book actually from Sid Roth. It's Supernatural, on a video I ordered from him. And that video, again, was about pleading the blood of Jesus. If you can find it in the shop, you can order it online. If you buy it and read it, it has fantastic testimonies. Even people who found it difficult to receive the Holy Ghost baptism, after using this and pleading the blood of Jesus, started speaking in tongues. Jesus is Lord. Remain blessed. Be equipped with the word of God. In Jesus' name.